Hey guys, another focus stream. At the beginning here, I'll be just organizing the layer structure. You can see in the top left, just trying to group assets into, groups so that they're easier to isolate and then be able to focus on key areas. You'll also notice that the hierarchy on the left is using some type of modified plugin. It's called Enhanced Hierarchy 2.0. I will link that in the description below if you want to check it out. The only other thing you might find interesting is there's also two hierarchy windows on the left side. The reason for this is I can use the little lock button on the top right of those windows in order to keep the folders from opening up when you select things. So with that in mind, I can keep the structure pretty organized in the top hierarchy and then lock that so that those don't expand. And then when I need to move things around between hierarchies, I can actually grab those from the bottom window and drag them into the top window. So it's kind of like folder structure. You can see I'm turning off all of the layers now that I don't need to see and just focusing on a single one. This makes it way easier to just kind of focus in and like actually focus on just one spot and get the details just right in those areas. The rest of the video is basically just kind of clean up work and then starting to prop out some smaller areas now that I have the structure kind of set up. It's going to be much easier going forward. We'll go ahead and time lapse this for a little while and then we'll slow it back down when I start getting to a little bit more detailed propping near the end of the video. So you can see I was just looking from pretty high up and kind of decided that this area that we're focusing it on right now basically was too samey. Like everything in this area is very similar. So I end up deciding to break it open, exposing a lot of dirt, and then using it as an excuse to bring roots and vines out from the tree in a modular sense. These quads you see me placing around as well with the dirt on them are just basic tessellated quads that are being tessellated and displaced by the material. And the material is made in substance. Tilting these blocks around allows us to get some pretty interesting transitions from the stone to the dirt. People always ask me, like, why? How come you're modeling in the stones when you could just maybe make like a tileable texture? And this is one of the reasons: is to have that geometric difference in height allows for you to move your materials and geometry within each other and actually have some natural breakup instead of very hard, harsh lines. Here you're seeing me grab a cluster of assets that I know I'm going to end up using again and just copying them off and then starting to place them around. It's really important, I think, with those little smaller rocks like these guys, is to actually move them around along the edges where you have the transition between a hard edge and then another surface that's like a greater angle, like a 90 degree turn or 45, just because that'll help you mask the issue that 3D art tends to have early on, which is like a tangent line or a hard edge transition. So if you can put like other details or shapes in place of those lines, you tend to get a much more organic and realistic looking scene. Now these vines that I'm placing around with the grass and rocks, the vines kind of work. I feel like I need another shape just because you start getting a pretty repetitive pattern. I get around it a little bit by pushing some of the roots into the ground and only showing a little bit of it. It's like it kind of works. This type of work is probably my favorite. It's like you already have all of the pieces, right? And then you're just like thinking about how to position things and make stuff look realistic in the way that it's connected together. And yeah, it's fun. There's a lot of exploring that happens during this time. You'll see me scale some assets ever so slightly, like in the decimal range. And for the most part, that can be okay, but you got to really make sure that you don't go maybe past like 1.5 the scale in any X, Y, or Z direction while you're working in production. It tends to cause issues, not only with TechR, but possibly your engine. So here you'll see me pull out this tool that I use from time to time called Epic Pen, which allows you to kind of draw on the screen. So see, what I'm trying to do is break up this wall just because I feel like it's just a little too straight, and that gives that 3D look that we're talking about. So it's like just exploring shape change and damage, see what we can do. I end up using a pretty simple what do you call it? A simple solution to it in the end, just because it worked. It's just grabbing a cluster of rocks that have the grass skirt around them, and placing them just to break up that edge. That's basically it for this video, but thanks for watching, and don't forget to subscribe to the channel, leave a comment. I'm always answering questions in the comments if you leave anything, and don't forget that there's a Discord, and then I stream on Mondays and Thursdays at 8 p.m.